Kanske jag får det.
Kör.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to the great outdoors. We have brought out a picnic of sorts.
We picked these ourselves. We just kidding. From the grocery store.
We're having a painting picnic. And we were hoping you might join us for painting picnic.
Yes. I personally have not painted in a lot of years.
Many years.
Many years. Mm. I enjoy finger painting, but I also enjoy using paint brushes. So
we have those. We have multiple paint brushes.
We are equipped with a variety of good paint brushes.
Yes.
A variety of paint colors.
We're doing acrylic.
Acrylic.
Acrylic painting.
We got some canvases.
And we are ready to be creative. Ooh. Oh my gosh, that was terrible.
I
hated that.
I hated it too. I'm so sorry.
I'm really hoping that while we're painting, some butterflies might flitter across the screen because we've been seeing them around.
Yeah. And hopefully the stink bug doesn't come back.
Hopefully not.
We're hoping for butterflies, maybe some ladybugs.
Did he get removed from the premises? Oh, poor Kai.
Well, we just moved him over to a different log.
We still have love for him, but he's just too icky boy, sticky boy. We couldn't take the risk.
Our whole picnic could be ruined by just one icky boy.
Just by one icky boy. Do you think we're gonna need scissors to get this off, or can we just claw it? Do you know which colors you're going to want to use yet?
I do not.
I think I'm going to try to just kind of like paint what I see.
Cool.
So I'm going to start with, that's not blue. Oh look, there's a little spider on my palette.
Oh, it is tiny. I can't decide if I want to, because you mentioned before, like, how cool it is to have two people painting the same thing and see how it turns out.
But I don't want to restrict you. If you want to do something abstract, then I'm like over here being like, I'm just going to paint a tree. I want you to follow your dreams.
I think I'm more comfortable doing abstract, at least for now, because I haven't painted in so long.
I think
I need
to,
like, warm back up too.
It'll be really cool if we end up with something extremely different.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
That'll be fun.
I like this berry color. Ooh, it's like,
sometimes the paint just really doesn't match the color on the bottle.
I think what I'm gonna do is have like one side of the canvas be like sort of like reds and pinks, sort of, and then have it go into like maybe like purple-ish and then blue, so that it's like color
gradation,
I guess.
I got something
pretty. And then I just do like weird stuff on top of that when it dries.
We love weird stuff.
So I'll start with the reds.
I need a big brush.
I had this art teacher in high school who was like Bob Ross's number one fan, and he really wanted to be Bob Ross. And it was really cute because he like pretty much imitated him.
Really?
So like it was like the best art class ever because it was like Bob Ross wannabe teacher.
Was it relaxing? Or did
it was, and he would play Bob Ross videos during class.
Are you serious?
Oh, and I was like the only one in class who cared about art for some reason. And so I was like his favorite student because I would do things correctly. Then everyone else was just like really kind of mean to him, and I felt really bad.
That's so sad.
But, like, people were mean to him, and I was like, I'll be your teacher's pet, don't worry. And then he would let me hang out in that room and, like, paint during, like, different, like, study halls and whatever.
That's so cool. I wonder if he still remembers you, like, because I have had so many teachers that have made such an impact on me that, like, I still think about them now, but I don't know if they remember me or not.
I highly doubt he remembers me because I was really quiet.
Really?
I did not talk to, like, anybody in high school. Little spider, don't go on my canvas. You will die. You will die a sticky, sticky death. I guess I'm just intimidated because I haven't painted in so long. But I think I was a skeptic.
That's the beauty of the abstract, is that if somebody sees it and they don't like it, you can be like, well, you just don't get it. You're just not deep enough. You don't understand my vision. You could stop right here and it already looks cool. Like,
to hang a lot of paintings, like, in the bathroom.
Really?
Yeah, I just want to cover the wall with paintings in the bathroom. So I think this will be a nice bathroom painting. Were you just reaching for them when I asked for them?
I could sense that you needed them.
That is awesome. Man, looks like there's like a hellfire in the sky.
I like it. Do you think people ever paint with berry juice? There's this artist that I think that you follow too. She's the one who makes the harnesses. I think Shirlisa Moe.
Mm-hmm.
She paints with rose juice. And she makes videos where she makes the juice by chewing the petals in her mouth and spitting out the juice.
Oh my god, I need to watch.
Yeah.
There was a video she put out recently that I didn't watch yet. I just noticed it in my feed. And it's called Eating Flowers or something. ASMR Eating Flowers. And I'm like, hell yeah. This is what I'm here for.
It's my kind of content.
This is because I love edible flowers.
That's very fairy-like of you.
Oh, did you listen to that podcast I sent you by anything?
I haven't yet, but I actually screenshotted it when you posted on your story because I was like, that sounds so interesting, just like the premise of it.
So I've been listening to it from the first episode.
I was going to ask if you had an episode you recommended.
Yeah, the one that I texted you.
Oh, okay.
That is an episode that, I honestly recommend starting from, if you're a podcast listener, I recommend listening, like, start at the beginning because they're all really, really good. But the one that I sent you was talking about different types of artists, and I thought you would like it because he was talking about how, like, there are some artists that they have an immediate spark and they just do it and they make a masterpiece or whatever in like a very short period of time. And then there are other artists who agonize over their work for like years and years and years, and sometimes they just never finish anything. Hey girl, you wanna watch this podcast?
Get some sociological perspectives.
Are you into having an existential crisis after listening to a podcast episode?
Hey baby, existential crisis and cry?
Ruining your brushes.
No. Yeah, my last painting video, I ruined a bunch of my favorite brushes because I filmed the video all night, and then by the time I finished the painting, I was so sleepy I just like passed out on my bed without washing my brushes.
I do that with my makeup sponges.
Oh, it's so sad.
I heard footsteps. I think there's a creature.
A creature afoot?
There's a creature afoot. I just saw a lizard. But I don't think lizards make footsteps. Well, they make rustling noises. That's a rather large lizard. I'm having so much fun. I know this is really, really mellow, but I'm just overjoyed right now. Because I'm doing a lot of my favorite things all at once. And we are together. I mean, filming outside is like one of my favorite things ever. Paint water. Oh, that's a cool brush. It's very little.
It's a little baby one.
His berries are so good.
Mm-hmm. Berries and painting are just really a winning combination.
I'm really bad at it. Try it out.
At once?
On like a rotation or something.
Oh, no.
Kind of at once. It's really confusing. It's not very fun.
It doesn't sound like it.
professional.
A professional professional.
I'm a professional professional.
Mm-hmm.